likes me. So people always come and tell me like, me self, I'm forming, I'm not even kissing. You know the thing, eh? Even as, especially as ladies, or even guys inclusive, you might do something now and then it's like, cool.
Mm-hmm.
And then you just, let's say you have sex now. Yeah, man, focus. Okay. People now have sex and then people that are pushing you, do you get, like, just keep your dignity, because some people just give their life to Christ and move on and
you'll be the one that's sad
picking up your broken pieces. So imagine, like, so you now tell me, I'm stingy, I don't need to kiss, I don't need to do this, I don't need to do that. No, this guy is a Christian, we are both saved. So, focus, Joe. So that's how you now saw, looking at people that are saying. So that's how he now saw, he now came, you know this person now? No, he likes me. Oh,
yes.
So, this guy had a girlfriend who now come to host and, try to stay me.
Yes, yes.
But the time now, him and this guy, what's how his friend in Red House? He's chubby.
So, you're not giving me much to go by.
Anyway,
his name is not important.
He used to come, and then there was a time he came to hostel to look for me. I remember, you know those hostels now that they will have like cupboard. Like, cupboards that are not being used. You not touch a cupboard and look at this cupboard. But if it's touching like this, shit, nothing happens to the cupboard. Now that's the same way. It's comparing me to a cupboard.
Wait, as he touched the cupboard.
He touched the cupboard.
And nothing happened. So yes, that means if he touches...
nothing will happen. Everything is inside.
So what did he want you guys to know?
My sister, he wanted us to run shows.
Shows
and nothing. We used to call it like romance.
I'm making out.
Shows. Running shows. Same for shows. People come and run shows upstairs. Empty class.
Empty class.
So that's what I'm going to message you and I'll be like, remember when we used to?
To do it in dusty rooms.
So, I think I don't know what else to talk about. Let's talk about general like bullying.
God.
Bullying.
I think like the other day when you made a post on Instagram talking about how like seniors will send people without money and be like, oh, go and buy this, go and buy that, and then bring change. Well, they didn't really like, one senior tried to do it with me, but then when she realized that I was not in the mood, she asked me to go. She knew my guardian was someone by very influential at the time, so she now let me go. Could have an experience. I think when I was in GS1, I had just come and everything, and then this senior called me to come to her room. I think you were on you now. Okay, you were not on you had left before you came. She had a sister in SS2. She now called me to come to her room to either wash her clothes or something. I was in, this is me, just one, to wash her clothes. And I'm like, well, okay. I think I now like started. And then, no, she now like said I should come. I should leave the clothes. And then I came. I don't even know what happened. Next thing, she's like, I should squat. I'm pretty sure it was nothing. Like, I'm pretty sure I didn't even do anything. She's like, I should squat. And then I squatted. She's like, in fact, I should carry the bunk, like, on my back.
Wow.
I swear, that's like our single iron bed.
Wow.
I should squat on that and, like, carry it. So I think as I was doing, and I did it now, because I mean, I was in just when I was naive. I did not have the mind that I have right now. So as I now did it, someone now came to call me. I think maybe some of my said girls had reported or something. So, like, a teacher or a hostel mistress now came to call me. I think at that point I was crying and I went to go and tell my guardian. So then, yes, it was an SS3 girl who came and saw me and wondered why an SS2 girl was asking me to carry the bunk. So she now called me to my room. I think I even had a cousin in SS3. So she now called the girl, asked her to go and squat under the sun in that courtyard. She was squatting. Then I told Mr. Mubai. Then he punished her. So like ever since that incident, she now had it out for me. But then she never really like acted on it again because of the first experience. And I'm like, obviously, you just sit down and decide to be so mean to somebody for no reason.
It's lack of esteem.
Exactly, lack of self-esteem.
It's just like, something, and most times, these things may have happened to them even more worse, so they want to pass it.
Exactly, but that's where the mistake is. The fact that someone treated you badly doesn't mean you should keep displacing that anger and aggression onto other people.
Because they didn't know better, to be honest. Like, if you know, like, they say if you know better, you would do better.
But it's not an excuse.
I think for me, like, I didn't really, as in, I think first of all, me, I was never really someone that was a bully. I don't think, like, when I just came out, even like timid. I was kind of, I remember that even Charlotte used to tell me, like, you don't have mass talk to juniors. Like, I was not really that kind of, funny enough, when I talk to people, they actually think I was a bully. Honestly, I don't know. Not the evidence, was I a bully? No, I was actually more like the end of people talking, okay, juniors would just take advantage. But it was not later, I think later, I was just basically in between.
When you got to SS3, you had then really that stage where you're not going to take
I'm not going to, honestly, there was this person I was saying, I remember there was the time I called her. And she was not doing slow. I was going to call a junior. I was not wondering, like, is it because I joke with these people? So when she came, I was about to hit her slippers. I got that held and I just leave her. I think I punish her or something. Because I'm like, me, so I'm not a person that has people's time. So when I call, it's not as if.
Exactly.
Doesn't mean she's not be nappy. You have a carrying shoe that. So I'm going to beat her. I was so angry that was the first time I said,
remember the time I slapped all their backs? I think when it says three, it was just two girls. I think they left a note on my bed.
No.
Like, I don't know. You know, I think we had to do something stupid and we're like addressing our set. Like, it was an anonymous note from them to us. Something stupid. And then they now decided to leave the note on my bed for me to find and then, you know,
pass
give
the
to
message.
The authority. So it's me who is into the messenger. So I called them, all of them, and I'm like, who put this note here? They couldn't answer. I think at that point, I was already pissed off.
Do you know, and there were so specific girls that actually gave their mind in SS2. The Manora, Sheila, or Ilu, I remember now.
And I'm like,
those are the girls that gave their mind.
I think at that point I was allowing a few of them call me by my name. Yeah. But that doesn't mean give you the right to, like, why couldn't you put it on somebody else's bed? It's not my bed.
Exactly.
So I decided to line all of them up, bend their backs, just slapping them one by one. And then they now went, I don't know how they now heard about it in school. Like Uncle Collins, now because Uncle Collins, I think it was Uncle Collins or Mr. Ivy, one of them. That's Mr. Ivy, sorry. Mr. King, one of them, then I called me to the office and I said she kneeled down, blah blah blah. That whether first I'm going to go home on suspension, this one, that one. I'm like, what did I do? But now it's funny, but then I wasn't finding it funny because I had an impeccable record.
You were you perfect?
Guy, I dodged perfection, but he found his way to me.
Which one?
Danny Hall of Punctuality.
What's Blessing was Blue House?
Yeah, Cuckoo was that post then when she got debadged, and I'll go her back. It's just that I was going to be suspended. But eventually, this is how the community service. I didn't end up doing it. Oh yes, another thing. Most of the teachers thought I was rude. I don't know why.
The time you were rude.
Okay, I was.
You were sassy.
I was. Okay, yes, like, I was sassy.
You see, even now she's doing like this.
Oh God.
You were
see,
like.
I wasn't rude. Per se.
5 hours later.
Because like people always had this misconception about me. Another person like, okay, you already feel a certain way. I feel like you prejudged me, so I kind of treat you that way. So I think I was in. I think Auntie Choma's room. I wanted to make a phone call to my mom, and then Jella was there. So we're joking about something. It was an inside joke and everything, but she obviously didn't know what it was about. And I decided, she thought it was what's it called? I was being mean, and she's like, "Get out of my room."
Who?
Auntie Choma. And I'm like, why? She now said that whether she said I should get out of her room. I said I don't even want to make a phone call again, and then I left the room. Same thing with Auntie Jumoke. That one also thought I was rude, but when they now got there. When they now got to know me and they realized that, okay, I'm actually, you know, an angel.
Bruh.
They now,
you know, was so mean to me when I just came.
I'm like, I just knew you were going to bring this, you know.
Yes.
I wasn't mean to you.
She was so mean to me. Like, I was just this very innocent new girl that everybody loved.
If anybody
so
can
fine.
Say I was mean to David, it would be Hamida. Not me.
Exactly. You see, I mean.
Can admit that I was mean to Hamida, but I wasn't mean to you.
You were kind of until like when I became close. You would not be giving this attitude like.
Which
attitude? Like, you used to feel like a bam. You're a bam girl. Bam. She used to feel so bam. And
see,
then,
when I met Zulu was a day student, I was in the hostel.
So and then she felt like you had been like. She no. felt like a short. Like, she used to feel like. She was upper class. That's what I said.
It's the upper class.
No,
it wasn't like
usual,
that.
As usual, she just fell in love with me because I am lovable. I'm a sweetheart.
Let's go with that. Yeah, it's your video. It's your channel. Let's make
that's
her happy.
True. And I remember, dying in all days, people would have been exchanging turkey for. They said, can you give me your Wednesday chicken for your Friday?
Friday
your Wednesday egg.
Wednesday indomie
for Friday chicken. Nah, she's someone like 20 and likes, you know me.
Yeah.
She never exchange then on Friday. You know, be expecting somebody's chicken. Oh God. And remember if a senior is on your table, they will not take the meat.
Yeah.
There's a time my senior took all the meat, happy fish, and left us with the plain food.
It's
it was so painful. Actually, it was so painful because
that never happened
you know when you're just thinking like, let me come and eat.
Like, seriously, though, like, a lot of things that they did in secondary school are just not necessary.
But I think because I'm like, basically, some of these things, you know, shall mature from a lot of things. Yeah. And this is like 5 years now.
Yeah, wait, no, this is not 5 years post graduation, but this is 5 years. 5 years. Almost 6 years.
I think
it's more than smaller. 6 years. We already graduated by this time.
Yeah, so it's been six years plus. Wow, I feel like now I'm not really like a citizen. I'll be, I don't know what to even say, but I feel more mature.
Yeah, people that entered when we're leaving would have already graduated by this point. Wow. So,
oh my god, I'm still loading. It's time to get married. Sorry, man, I'm bringing a man. God is doing it. God is working on something.
He's working on
before something. You know it's now, just say, I'll make a video, I'll just raise my just hand.
Okay, once you I get engaged, like, every like, small thing I'm doing.
Wow, imagine.
Hi, people.
Like the kind of people you don't want to accept if you are single. You will not say,
pass me that broom.
You're just like, hello. Even if you used to wave it to your right hand.
Like, I don't need to say my name is Mrs. So and so before you know. I'm married.
Hello.
When I step in the building, the bling will let you know.
Everybody's bling. I mean, all my bling go off. Anyway, guys, we have come to the end of the video. Can you relate to any of this? Particularly if you went to a boarding school? Yes. I'm sure you'll be able to relate to one.
Comment
of
down below.
No, I must say this one. There was a time. This girl.
Which girl, sir?
I don't know, she said 10 seconds. You know that thing, 10 seconds to leave the hostel. 10, 9. So, when I got to the gate, it wasn't her count. When I got to the 10th count to leave the hostel. So, when I got to the front of the hostel, I was like, ah, thank God I've left the hostel. And I started walking, I wasn't running. Mm-hmm. Because it was the 10th count to leave the hostel. So, she now heard, I went to go and tell the other senior what I said.
What did you say that was wrong?
Because he said 10 count to leave the hostel. I was like, as in, she made me do 90 degrees. 90 degrees squared. But anyway, like I said, they are calling again now.
Mm.
I don't hold on, but some of
you like and this thing, like all these things that they did back then, right now they can't even try it. So for you,
it's just that feeling of you want to feel like you can dominate somebody, and it's not really a good thing. Yes. Like I don't know if it's the same in boarding schools in different countries, but like I said, if you're in boarding school in Nigeria, I'd probably be able to relate to some of these.
You have worse stories to tell.
Exactly, some people may have more stories to tell.
Unfortunate.
Do you remember this one? In fact, I'm telling you, I didn't want to, but I must say it. Then when they said that people should put mirror under their private part, they said we should stand in JSS 2 JSS 3, because like stand and put a mirror under your thing.
And like, to be honest, floor, I didn't even know what was happening.
I mean, they didn't even they called me,
and then they just, there was no even mirror when I was there. They just called. I can't remember what they asked me, and then they asked me to go. But people that they actually like were looking under with other sets of people, but that didn't happen to like
disgusting. I remember they brought them out and they suspended them.
Some of them, and
remember,
they really embarrassed
them. Remember, Mr. Abu would say, if you come out,
you have four to like, boys really wanted to like know the gist and know what happened. Like, I think even up to when we went back, but yes, David was still bugging me to tell me what happened. Tell him what happened.
Are you serious? Are you serious? So, well, thank God. Like I said, that is it. Let's not talk too much.
Yeah.
That's everything for now. Anyway, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Make sure you share it.
Make sure you share it.
And of course, do click that subscribe button and turn on the notification bell.
Get my girl the subscriber that she needs.
Thank you. Please subscribe for more premium content like this.
Yes, like this.
I remember the same woman to make a beauty. Did I do for welcome to my channel before?
So yeah.
Anyway, if I didn't say, hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I have my
friend. You did when you introduced me.
Okay. Yes, I did. Yeah. Okay. All right then. Catch you later, guys. Bye. What do you have to say? Last word.
Peace and love. Be kind to people. Please show love to other people, and love will find you in return.
It's true.
Yeah.
What you give, you get.
Exactly.
Okay. Bye. Thank you for coming.
Thank you for having me.
Let's post for the. Let's post
for the thumbnail.
Yeah. Since we're doing videos about seconds, let's just do like
a like sorrowful looks.
I can just laugh like. Okay, I think that would do.
That should do, yes.